Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO DPC Technology. And today I'm gonna dive into how we design Unifi systems here at DPC Technology. And specifically, I'm gonna go into two pieces of software. One's called Innerspace that runs on any of your Unifi controllers, and the other one's called Design Center, and it's a web-based app. So we're gonna compare the differences between the two and see which one might be right for you. So let's jump right in. All right, so let's look at Innerspace first. I'm gonna show you how to get there. So I'm on Jack's UNVR Pro. I'm gonna go into the device itself, and it is just an app, just like the other apps that you can run on, you know, a Cloud Key or a UDM Pro. It actually runs on the UNVR as well. I'm gonna click on Innerspace. That's where I'm doing ours here. As you can see, I've already imported a map of our office on Innerspace, and we'll go in through Innerspace and we'll take a look at it. For Design Center, it's very simple. It's just an app on the web, and you just go to design.ui.com and log in. You can create a login if you don't have one already, and you can log in. And you can see I've also updated our site plan there as well. In this one, just to kind of differentiate, because I'm gonna jump back and forth between the two of them, I'm gonna go into preferences, and I'm gonna set the Design Center to dark mode, which I know most of you like dark mode. It is available in Design Center. It is not available in Innerspace. So that's one of the differences right off the bat. But anyways, for the rest of this video, you will see dark mode will be the Design Center, which is the web-based app, and Innerspace will be the one that is hosted on our UNVR Pro. So first and foremost, you'll notice there's a lot of similarities between the two programs. But the main thing is Innerspace is going to take the devices that you already have installed on that controller or device and bring them in automatically. So you can see on the right here, this is a list of different devices that I have on this UNVR Pro. You notice that these cameras are all different ones that I have throughout the office. One thing to note here is some items may be items that you have had in the past and don't have on anymore. Like these items over here are ones that I test every once in a while. They're not always on, they're not on right now, so I've left them over here. But sometimes I will drag them into the plan. But before I get ahead of myself, how would we get to this spot? You know, where do you start from the beginning? If I go to the gear here, it gives me the option to edit the plan, rename the plan. Now, Innerspace only gives you the option to run one main plan, because obviously, because it's just basically an outline of what's already installed on this device. So you're not gonna have your UNVR Pro with multiple sites. It's only on this site. So you only have one plan to edit. That's one main difference. I can change the image here, but I can only import the image one time or have one image that I'm looking at. I can import it multiple times and write over it, but I can only have one main site plan. You'll also see in here, I can rename this if I wanted to. Change some of the icon sizes. And this one's kind of nice. Once you've brought your plan in, we're gonna draw these walls all in, and I can take the original plan and kind of either make it go all the way away or have some different kind of a level of transparency, which is nice. Obviously on this one, my plan's got a lot of information in the back, so I actually turn it down a little bit, but it is also nice to see where cubicles are placed and that kind of stuff. I can rotate the image, I can remove the image and import it again. That's basically how you get the back image in here, and it's very similar on Design Center as well. Once I've got it in there, you see this draw wall option, and if I click the down arrow, I can get walls, concrete, drywall, or glass, or rooms, which is basically gonna draw squares. So what I did, and I've already done this for the sake of time, is I've gone in here and I've just drawn the walls in. So let's draw the walls around the garbage receptacle. These are concrete walls. I would just click and drag. It would continue to draw a square. If I want to stop it, I click the escape key and I'm queued up to draw again. I would draw this back like this. Little tiny kick walls sometimes are hard for it. So I typically don't get that down to that level of detail, because if I do, I'll go ahead and draw one in here. It's gotta be like 3 feet before it sees it, and that's longer than that is, it's probably just a one brick kick wall. So if I wanted to get rid of that, I can push escape again, get to my arrow, click on it, and then it brings up these icons. These icons are kind of handy. I could change the material, add a point in the middle if I wanted to make this more complex and like put a bend in it or something, and I can change the orientation of the next segment there, which are all handy kind of tools. It's pretty self-explanatory. If you've ever kind of drawn anything with any program, it's pretty easy to do it. If I wanted to say there's a glass wall there, I could just change the wall to glass, and I would say there's a glass wall here. What's pretty cool about this is it's taking a look at the materials so that when I add in access points or cameras, it's gonna know whether it's going to be blocked by what is in front of it, which is really very cool. So you can see I've already drug in a bunch of cameras here, but let's say I didn't have this viewport, I can delete it and I'll go back over here. It knows the viewports here. Like I said, all of these are items that the UNVR is seeing. So it knows that I have this viewport. I can drag it and simply drop it. Super easy. I can reposition it by just dragging it around. Same as the walls, if I click on it, it's gonna give me the options to delete it. If I had a switch here, it would give me the option to drag a cable from that to the switch. It works the same way for cameras, so I'm gonna go ahead and delete this boardroom camera. Then I'll go back over here, grab the boardroom camera, and I'll put it back in here again. It gives me this option here to change the orientation of the camera. And so that's kind of cool. I'll put it back here in the corner. I'll see what my coverage is. That looks good for the room. That's where I should have it. And then I can also, you notice I've got all my other cameras in here. I can turn on what all of my coverage is for my camera. I will tell you occasionally on this, it doesn't show exactly, you know, I have to like, this camera's on and it's right, but it's not drawing it correctly. This one is on and it's correct, but it's not drawing it correctly. And I have to kind of mess around a little bit, which is a little annoying. It seems to be a little more flaky than the Design Center, which seems to always click in there. That could be something with my video card or me recording to OBS right now. Nevertheless, I am noticing some anomalies with it when I play with it. It's very simple to use this. I think it's definitely great to kind of see if I put these ones here, this is where I, you know, this is what I'm gonna get from them. When you first drag the image in, you can see down here, it says ceiling height and scale. It's gonna ask you for what your ceiling height is. We have 12 foot ceilings here. I just took a known line, and I think this is 113 feet wide of our building. And I just keyed it to that and said that was the scale. And then it automatically tells you what the coverage is. One thing you'll notice here that is happening on my system in particular is I have different controllers for different things. This particular controller that is on is not seeing my Wi-Fi. My Wi-Fi is on a separate controller. So if I go to the Wi-Fi planner, you're not seeing anything here. It's not detecting my WAPs in the office. And I don't have an option to show all or see them all. They're just not there because they don't exist. That's one thing, you know, it just is going to be for the controller that you're on at that time. So if you've got multiple sites, multiple devices that are controlling things, you're not gonna see that. Cool little program. When we switch over to the Design Center, it will show you the Wi-Fi mapping, and it is very similar to the Wi-Fi. I mean, it's identical to the Wi-Fi mapping. So without any further ado, I'll jump over there. And so this is what it's gonna show you when you click your Wi-Fi mapping. It's gonna show you what you're getting in the different areas as far as coverage. If you click on the display options here too, you can change frequencies, and it's showing you the 2.4 gigahertz band where everything is good, where it's not, or where it is in the 5 gigahertz band, where it is in the 6 gigahertz band. That does the same thing in Innerspace if we were back over here. Just a couple quick little things in here before we get out of here. There is also display options here. So you can see here, if I had Wi-Fi, I could do the same coverages there. It also lets me look at, take each device and say, do I want to show name and model? Or do I want just model? Or do I want just name? All cool stuff. And obviously that's pulling those names directly from the device, which is pretty cool. So under cameras, you can also show your resolution and your frame rate. Very strangely, that was working a few minutes ago, not working now. I'm not sure if it's because I'm recording with OBS right now or not. Again, with Design Center, some of these things are a little bit flaky, but that being said, it's there, it's on your system. I can also change the color of the background writing for each one of these cameras. If you look at knock three there, if I go to low, it has it with a white background. And if I go to none, it just writes it on top of everything. I just figured out why it's not showing me the frame rate and the resolution. It's because I was on Wi-Fi. If I go over to camera, it shows me that again. So I can add just resolution, just frame rate. Pretty cool. This is a really simple design program, but powerful. I think it's probably worth your time and energy if you have your home or office and you wanna be able to kind of plan where you wanna put things and see what you have currently installed. That's pretty cool. A couple wish lists for this is that we get a little bit more details about the cameras, maybe get some output. And I'm sure the upgrade path is gonna be really cool as they update this in the future. So let's jump over into Design Center. A lot of the same things that you had in Innerspace, but much, much more powerful. You'll notice right off the bat, there are more menu items and there is this left menu bar. I wanna go down the left menu bar real quick. You start off in floor plans and you can have multiple floor plans here, which is cool. So, you know, I have the outside floor plan here and I've got the inside floor plan here, or the site plan and the inside plan. You can then go to topology, and if you've got everything connected in here, this topology will work. But there's a little bit, it's not automatic like it was in Innerspace. It's not drawing all this. You're manually putting all this in, and you have to kind of connect everything. You get an equipment list. So once you've done your plan, it'll show you what your equipment list is. And you could actually go right to the store and buy it. You can also do it per plan, or you can do it for the whole site or multiple sites and check out all at once. You can change the items, add or remove the items. It's pretty cool. And then you could organize things into projects. So, you know, this office is one project. I could have another project where I had multiple site plans there. So if you are a UI professional and you're out there using UI on a daily basis, this is a really cool way to be able to plan your projects and get your budgets together for what it's going to cost to go out there and purchase the items. And, you know, even giving you to one click of going to checkout and grabbing those items. It'll also show you which items are available and not available. Let's bring in a plan. And I'm just going to go back to our floor plan, like I said before. Same as before, you're going to bring in your plan. You can edit your plan and kind of, you know, do the same things as you could before. Rotate it, change the opacity. Very, very similar there to Innerspace, actually identical to Innerspace. And then you can draw the walls, same exact as we did before with Innerspace. I'm not going to go through that too much. But you can also in here draw cabling, which if I want to draw cabling from one device to another, I can do that. And it's going to give me an estimate of the amount of cabling that I'm going to need, which is really cool. I'll just do a simple one. Let's just say I have cable route here from this device to this device. And I was going to go straight line there. It's going to tell me how many feet it is and how much cable. It's going to keep tallying up how much cable I'm going to need. I'm going to go another cable route. And I'll do this one a little bit more like I really would. I'm gonna go from here to here and then to here. And it's gonna tell me the length of that, which is cool. How much cable I would need to do it. Same as before, I can go to these cables, I can delete my segments, and I can change the route, add a point to them, just like I did with the walls, which is very nice. I'm gonna delete all these just because they're messing up my jam. And then the biggest thing here is the place device button. If I click on place devices, now it is a catalog of everything that Unifi has. So I can go through gateway switching, Wi-Fi, cameras and security, door access, phone systems, smart building stuff, and accessories. So, you know, I can get pretty much anything they have through here and put it out on my plan. So if I had a G4 instance, I can just click on it, I can drag it and put it where it really is. You can see that's super simple and very similar to what we had before. In my office where I've got 1,000 G4 domes, I can also click once and just do a copy. So every time I add another one, I can just click on that one and boop, boop, boop. Very simple, very easy. And that's gonna add to my project. It's gonna add to my list down below. It's gonna add to my devices and my topology. All that stuff's gonna happen all at once. Pretty cool stuff. And you know, at scale, if you're doing a big office, this is definitely the way you would want to design it. I can come in here as well. I can go through and put on device name and port that it's plugged into, which will be really nice as well. I'm not going to that level here in this demo, but if I put in a switch and I routed it back to the switch, I can tell you which port everything is on. Model name, you know, sometimes that's probably more than you want to see. Maybe it's not. So I can also, if I click the little button up here, I can start a new template. So like if I was doing a new stadium, hotel, school, whatever, it gives you a whole kind of template to start with. And that template has the basic rack mount stuff over here. So not only can I just see the cameras and stuff, I can actually build out a full rack. And just like before, you know, I can add stuff, remove stuff here, or remove these down below. I was playing before and add them. And I can expand with core technologies, and let's just say we're gonna put in an NVR and we'll go with a UNVR Pro, and there it is. I can move it up, I can move it down. If I wanted to add a switch, same thing. I can add additional switching capacity. We'll add one of these guys. We'll go back in here. There it is. I can move it down. I can put another patch panel in. You get the idea. Pretty cool stuff. Let me go into add a bunch of my 8 terabyte drives, you know, and it's just adding it to my list. So then when I go back over and I go back into regular mode, equipment list, all that stuff, it's gonna be that Pro Max 48 port. It's all added to my plan and then it's ready to check out there. So with Design Center, it's a much more powerful piece of software. It's made to help you design a full office implementation, and it's really for a professional. So that being said, if you are a home user and you really want a really nice plan, be able to budget it, take a look at it, know how much cable you're gonna need, and really have a cool plan, this is a great way to do it. The only thing about this is it's not dynamic and it's not drawing in what you already have into your plan. So it's not looking at your controller and saying, you already have four G5 Pros and bringing them in and knowing their names and all that kind of stuff. So really it's two different flavors. I think for the professional, the Design Center is probably more aimed for you. And for the home user, the Innerspace is probably more designed for you. That being said, I'm just touching the surface of what you could do here, especially in Design Center. You probably can go pretty deep here. You really could have a lot of fun in here. With that being said, I'd love to know what you guys are using Innerspace and Design Center for, or if you're using them at all. If you have any tips or tricks, please leave them in the comments down below. We do videos like this weekly, so if you like this kind of stuff, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.